ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this performance of The Phantom of the Opera. For your safety, please take a moment to locate your nearest emergency exit. In case of an emergency, please evacuate in a safe and orderly manner following the house attendant's directions. Please take this opportunity to turn off all mobile phones. We would like to remind you that for the safety of the performers and for copyright reasons, the taking of photographs and the use of audio and video recording equipment is strictly prohibited. Thank you.
A moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Rene. Proceed, proceed!
Monsieur. Sad to return! Signor.
Monsieur Rene, our chief repetiteur, rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sacri tanto final and vino. Let on what my bones are eating us. Tomorrow we shall break the chains of Rome.
My
imminent retirement, I can now tell you that these were all true. And it is my pleasure to introduce to you the two gentlemen who now own the Opera Populaire, Monsieur Richard Firmin and Monsieur Gilles André. Gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, of course. I've experienced all your greatest roles, Signora.
Piace.
And Signor Ubaldo Piangi.
An honor, Signor.
Piace. If I remember rightly, Alyssa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder, Signora, if, as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, Monsieur Reyes objects.
My manager commands. Monsieur Reyes.
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient,
Signor. I don't think there's much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Conting.
La Carlotta will be back.
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
God in heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house. Commands that you continue to leave Box 5 empty for his use. And reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you can afford more, with the Vicomte de Chandy as your patron.
Madame, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
Yes, in our box.
Madame, who is the understudy for the role.
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Dyer can sing it, sir.
The chorus girl?
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well. Can you believe it? A full house that we have to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
She's doing nothing for my nerves.
Don't fret, Emma.
But not so distant day. When you are far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for
such from decrease. Come, We rehearse. Now.
A single refund.
Greed.
Richard, I think we've made quite a discovery in this diet.
Here we are, Monsieur the Governor.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, Monsieur.
Thank you.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Daae, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. But after all the trouble I took, I was just 14, soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Yes. Oh, Rouse, who is you?
Christine. If Lottie let her mind wander.
You remember that too.
Little Lottie thought, am I fond of dogs?
Or a goblins of shoes? Or of riddles of frogs?
Those picnics in the attic. Of chocolates.
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories of the North.
No, what I love best not, he said, is when I'm asleep in my bed and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
When I'm in heaven, child, I will send the angel of music to you. Well, Father is dead now, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
There's no doubt of that. But now, we go to supper.
No, Frog! The angel of music's very strict.
I shan't keep you up late.
No,
then you Frog. Must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes. It's blood.
Ralph!
Thank you. We all go. let your dream begin, let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the
must return. Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Will she sing?
Here, I have an
me see it.
Please! Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance. Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of Il Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy, and put Miss Daae in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Daae plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored, a disaster
beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine. Christine!
Whatever next? This is insane!
This is the vehicle to put on!
Indeed, can you believe this? The man is mad!
Don't take orders!
This guy will be playing my page boy! A silent rogue!
Carlotta will be playing the lead!
You don't deserve her!
It's useless crying! No! Your public
prepares
a
shining
possibility.
Your voice
will
be
heard.
sitting in box 5.
Do you really think that's wise, monsieur?
My dear André, there would appear to be no seats available other than box 5.
Lordship Shaw would die of shock. His lordship is a laughing stock.
Should he be suspected, God protect him.
Shake, shake, shake.
This fearless lady is bound for
Hades. Shake, shake, shake.
Nothing like the old operas.
All the old scenery.
The old singers.
The old audience.
Every seat so.
A disaster beyond imagination.
Why? Who can this be?
Gentle wife, I admit your loving husband. My love, I am called to England on affairs of state and must leave you with a new maid. I'd gladly take the maid with me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect my own bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe. But dear,
ballet now.
Christine. Christine. is. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be for freedom, as day turns dry for tears. I'm here, with you beside me, to guard you and to guide you.
Beside me,
you will guard me.